हेलो किड्स, वेलकम अगेन। टुडे वी विल डिस्कस टू टॉपिक्स। वन इज इन कंटिन्यूशन ऑफ द बॉडी मास, दैट इज द रूल ऑफ बॉडी मास, एंड दिस आई हैव ऑलरेडी डिस्कस्ड इन द प्रीवियस चैप्टर। एंड द सेकंड वन इज वन प्रॉपर्टी ऑफ अ ट्रायंगल। सो फर्स्ट लेट अस स्टार्ट विद रूल्स ऑफ बॉडी मास। वी हैव ऑलरेडी डिस्कस्ड दैट वट आर द थ्री डिफरेंट टाइप्स ऑफ ब्रैकेट्स which we are used in by solving the body mass, and let us see which three types of brackets I have told you. The first one is common bracket, and the second one is curly bracket, and the third one is square bracket. These three brackets I have already told you, but the operation of these three brackets is from top to bottom. That is, first we have to solve the bracket common, then curly, then the square bracket. That is the result of this bracket. Whatever the number present in this bracket, we have to solve first, and the result of this bracket is solved with the numbers present in this curly bracket. Then after solving this curly bracket, then the result of the curly bracket is solved with the numbers present in the square bracket. So in this way we have solved all three brackets: first the common bracket, second the curly bracket, and third the square bracket. So let us see how we will solve these brackets in body mass system. Suppose we are having 2 plus 3. Now this number is present inside the bracket and it has positive sign. Both the numbers are having positive sign. So when we open this bracket, we will simply add these two numbers. But suppose there is a negative sign outside the bracket. So I have already told you, when there is a negative sign outside the bracket, then the sign of the numbers which are present inside the brackets, they are changed. So here both of them are positive, so we have to change the sign. Why? Because there is a negative sign outside the bracket. So when there is a negative sign, it will change the sign of the numbers which are present inside the bracket. So when we open this bracket, then change the sign. What is the sign of 2 here? It is plus, and the sign of 3 is also plus. So there is a negative outside the bracket. So when we open this bracket, then it becomes minus 2, minus 3. Both the signs are changed. Suppose let us take one number which is negative inside the bracket. Now again, there is a negative sign outside the bracket. So when we open the bracket, again we will follow the same rule. What? We have to change the sign of all the numbers which are present inside the bracket. So here 2 is negative and 3 is positive. It is minus 2 plus 3. So when we open this bracket, then we change the sign. So it becomes plus 2, and this plus 3 becomes minus 3. Now suppose let us take minus 3, plus 2, and minus 3. Again the rule is same. When we open this bracket, again the sign of the numbers is changed. So this plus becomes minus, and this minus becomes plus. So after opening the bracket, first see whether there is a negative sign outside the bracket or there is no negative sign outside the bracket. If there is no negative sign outside the bracket, then there is no change in the sign. So now let us solve these problems. I have already told you, those numbers having same sign, they are always added, and the sign of the resultant number is the sign of the number itself. That is, here both the numbers are positive. So first we have to add these numbers. So 2 plus 3, it is 5, and sign of both the numbers is positive, plus. So it's become plus 5. Here again the sign of both the numbers is negative, minus. So they are having same sign. So when the numbers are having same sign, they are again added. So 3 plus 2, it is 5. And the sign of the number is the sign of the number, and the sign of the answer must be same. So the sign of the numbers is negative. So the sign of the result is also negative. So this rule I have already discussed with you. If numbers having same sign, then they are added, and sign of the answer or result is the sign of the numbers itself. Here both are negative, the answer is negative. Both are positive, the answer is positive, and we have simply added the number 3 plus 2, 5. 3 plus 2, 5. Now the second case is, one is positive, one is negative. So when the sign of the number is different, then we have to subtract the number. Subtract the smaller from the bigger one. So 3 minus 2, it is 1. 3 minus 2 is 1. And put the sign of the bigger number in the answer. Here 3 is greater than 2, and the sign of the 3 is minus. So we have to put minus here. Now in this, again there is a difference of sign. One is negative, another is positive. So when there is a difference of sign, then what we have to do? We have to subtract the numbers. So 3 minus 2, again it is a 1. And which one is greater? 3 is greater. So, and the sign of the 3 is plus. So we have to put plus in the answer. So here we have divided both the operation in two groups. First one is, when the numbers having same sign, then they are added, and sign of the answer or sign of the result is the sign of the number itself. If the numbers are having different sign, then they are subtracted, and the sign of the answer or the result is the sign of the greater number. Here 3 is greater, so it is minus. Here 3 is greater, so it is plus. So this, in this way we have to solve the bracket. Now let us take, suppose there is a number with sign just before the bracket. Suppose it is, now here it is negative sign outside the bracket, but this 2 is also present just outside the bracket. Now this 2 is common to both. This 2 is common to both. So when we open the bracket, we will multiply both the numbers by 2, or first we will solve the bracket and the result of this bracket is multiplied by 2 and then change the sign. So I have to solve this in both the ways. First thing is, suppose we have to open the bracket. So when we open the bracket, first thing is to change the sign. Here it is plus, so it become minus, and 2 is multiplied by 3. Now plus, minus, again minus, and 2 is multiplied by 5. 2 3 ja 6, 5 2 ja 10. It is minus 16. This is the one method. Second is, either you can solve the bracket first. 5 plus 3, it is 8. 5 plus 3, it is 8. Now, when we open the bracket, first we have to change the sign. We put minus here because it is plus, and multiply. 2, 8, ja, 16. So it is again 16. So in both the case, you will get the same answer. Suppose there is a multiple bracket in the question. Suppose we have 2 or 3 brackets used in the operation. Suppose we are having 2 brackets here. One is common and one is curly bracket. Now, how to solve this question? According to the rule of Bodmas, what we have to done? We have to solve the bracket first, and when we solve the bracket, we have to follow this rule also. Here we have two operation, plus and multiplication. So what we have to done first? We have to multiply first, then add. So first we will multiply these two numbers. Now this is a continuous process, so you have to put equal to while solving the question. First copy all other things as it is. Now write this as it is and multiply these two. 3 5 ja 15 multiply this. Now again, what you have to do, again you have to solve the this bracket first. So here it is only addition is remaining. 15 plus 2, it is 17. Now here we have two operations, one is addition and one is subtraction. So first we have to add these two numbers. 17 plus 5, how much? 22. Now 22 is subtracted by minus 3 plus 22. If you know the answer, otherwise you can do like this also. Minus 3. You can take the carry, it becomes 12. 12 minus 3, it is 19 here. So when we subtract it, we will get 19. Now what will be the sign of this 19? 22 is greater, so the sign of the 19 is the sign of the greater number, that is plus. Now suppose there is a multiplication in the bracket which have different signs. Suppose a number is, suppose these two numbers are present inside the bracket. So when you multiply these two numbers, here it is minus and it is plus. When we multiply two different numbers having different sign, then the logic is changed. What is the logic? Minus multiplied by plus, it becomes minus. Plus multiplied by minus, again it is minus. So when there is a difference of sign, minus into plus, minus, plus into minus, minus. When there is a difference of sign, then it is negative, always negative. And when the sign is same, minus into minus, plus, plus into plus, it is plus. So no need to check whether which number is greater and whose sign is greater. So simply put the sign according to this rule. When there is a difference of sign and the numbers are multiplied, then they are always negative. And when the signs are same and the numbers are multiplied, then they are positive. So here the signs are different. One is positive, one is negative. 4 2 ja 8, sign is this. Suppose it is 2 multiplied by minus 4, again minus 8. Suppose it is minus 2 multiplied by minus 4, then minus 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 plus. So it is positive, and 2 multiplied by 4, it is again 8. So if the sign of the number is same, then the answer is positive. When the sign of the numbers are different, then the answer is negative. So remember these rules while solving the questions. I have given you some questions also, so you can solve. Now let us take one new property of triangle. You know that this word triangle, it is a combination of two words. Tree, which means three, angles. Tree is a Greek word, mono, bi, tri, tetra, penta, they are all Greek words. Tree means three. Three angles. So triangle is a figure which has three angles, 3 sides, 3 vertices. So today we will discuss one of its important property. Let us take ABC is a triangle. Now here we have 3 angles, angle A, angle B and angle C, and 3 sides AB, BC and AC, and 3 vertices A, B and C. So there is one important property in triangles: sum of all 3 angles of a triangle is always 180 degree. That is, if we add all 3 angles, the sum must be 180 degree. That is, if angle A plus angle B plus angle C is added, then we will get 180 degree. So here if 2 angles are given, then we can easily find the third one by shifting the given 2 in the right hand side. Suppose B and C are given, and if we want to find the angle A, then angle A is equal to minus, because we are shifting these 2 in this side, so it is angle B and angle C. If we want to find the angle B, if A and C is given, then it is 180 minus angle A plus angle C. Angle B is equal to 180 minus angle A and C. If we want to find the angle C, then it is angle B plus angle A. It means whatever the 2 angles are given, first you have to add these 2 angles and then subtract it from the 180. Then you will get the third angle. So the given 2 angles, they are added first and they are subtracted from the 180 degree, then you will get the third angle. So let us take one example. Suppose angle B and angle C is given. Suppose this is given 40 degree, it is given 60 degree, and you have to find the angle A. What is angle A? So again, use the, we know that angle A plus angle B plus angle C is equal to 180 degree. Now angle A, we have to find the angle A. This is 40 and 60 is equal to 180 degree. This is 60 plus 180 degree. Angle A is equal to 180 . So here you will get angle A. You can check also, if we add all these 3 angles, the sum must be 180 degree. That is 60 plus 40, 100, and 100 plus 80, 180. So in this way, you can find the all 3 angles. So kids, I am giving you some questions. You can solve it. Thank you, kids. Thank you very much.